Good morning to a brand new day. Time to learn and games to play. Learning things is so much fun. Learning is good for everyone.
Good morning, third graders. My name is Mrs. Nix, and I am so excited to be here with you and support you as you become amazing thinkers, readers, and writers. This morning, I have been thinking about all of the exciting books. I just finished off a series this last weekend, and it was so fun, but I'm not gonna lie, I'm a little heartbroken because I really wish there was another book to read in my mystery series. Are you reading a really fantastic series too? I would love to hear about it. So, super easy. If you want to write me a note, you can send it to the address that's popping up on the bottom of your screen. Tell me about what book you've been reading. Maybe it's a series of books. And I'm going to put one of these activity books in the mail addressed to you. It's completely free. So, here's another thing that is completely free is checking out books. You can do that by visiting your local library, checking out a book from your library at school, or you can go online and check out a book using the app Sora. Speaking of Sora, here in Fresno Unified, we love to celebrate our students that are checking out and using that app. And so we go through and we look to see who is checking out the most books, and we have a countdown of the top 5 schools for the highest number of checkouts. Are you ready to see who's in that 5th place? All right, let's check it out. It is Ewing Elementary. So great job, Ewing. Again, it's super easy to get on here. All you need to do is check out a book using Sora and maybe tell a classmate or two. I'd love to give your school a quick little shout out. Okay, are we ready to start this morning? Excellent. So this week we actually have 2 things that we're going to focus on. We're going to look at vowel team syllables, and then we're going to practice a whole bunch with Greek and Latin roots. To help get us started, let's warm up those brains, that super smart muscle we've got, and we're going to look at our high frequency words and read those. Now remember, high frequency words are those words that you see often in your reading, and you're going to use them often in your writing. So by third grade, it's really important that you're able to spell them. These are all review from the year. We're just going back. We're coming to the end of the year, so I want to make sure that we've give us another opportunity to take a glance at them. So if there's something here that you see and you think, I could practice spelling that, do it. Write it down on a post-it note. Practice it while you're brushing your teeth at night. By the end of the week, you'll have it. All right, let's go through. Let's read them together. You read them big and loud at home. I'll read them here. Let's go. Green, got, has, had, have, grow, hold, hot, hurt, and how. Nicely done, third grade. Okay, today let's look at our first 2 words. We have green, G-R-E-E-N, and got, G-O-T. Help me use these in a couple of sentences. All right, here's the first one. I to visit my best friend last Saturday. And the second one? I love seeing all the trees. Okay, we've got green and got. So I green to visit my best friend? That doesn't make any sense. How about I got to visit my best friend last Saturday? Nicely done. And I love seeing all of the green trees in the springtime for sure, right? Okay, so let's talk about a couple of things. I've got 2 kind of themes that we're going to practice a lot today. And the first one are vowel team syllables. Now we've talked about syllables. We've talked about breaking down those multisyllabic words. It's going to help us to chunk our words into smaller parts that we're able to read. And so this week we're going to practice all with our vowel team syllables. And so just a couple of little reminders about things. So this one's a great one. So every syllable in a word has 1 vowel sound. We want to remember that going forward because Sometimes it can trick us up because we'll think that every syllable has one vowel, but we really want to focus on there's a vowel sound, especially when we come to our vowel team. So here's a reminder about our vowel teams. Vowel teams are two or more letters working together in a word to form one vowel sound. So these aren't all of them, but I put a whole bunch of vowel teams up here because we know when we see A and I together, we can say A, and we can say A for A-Y, and we can say E for E-A, or we can say A for, like in the word bread. So, or F, like in bread. So these are several, but not all, of our vowel teams. So we're training our brains, and I'm going to take us back here and do a little practice, but we're training our brains to see those vowel teams so that we can divide our words into those syllables. Okay, so let's look right here. Here's the word complain. Do we see a vowel team? Okay, yes, right here. We've got A-I is our vowel team. Now remember how we divide our words into vowels? We're always looking, or into syllables. We're always looking for our vowels. So I'm gonna just kind of mark it right here. We've got a vowel right here, and our vowel team is gonna count for our second one. I also know that P-L is a consonant blend, so it's gonna stick together. So when I divide this, I know I've got two syllables, because I have two vowel sounds, I know that I'm going to have, I'm gonna divide it right there, because I've got my two vowel sounds come plain, all right? Let's try it one more time. So over here in this word, do I see my vowels? Well, yes, I've got vowels. Ooh, it's a vowel team, okay? So I'm just gonna mark it with one V, and I've got another vowel team. Let me underline them. I've got another vowel team right here. So just like we did in the past with our consonants, we want to split those consonants. We know we have two syllables, and we've got oat and meal, two syllables, breaking and chunking apart those words. Okay, let's go through. I have one more thing that I want to talk about because before we get to our practice, I want to do a little bit with some Greek and Latin roots, okay? So we're gonna practice several of them this week. I'm gonna just start with these four right now so that we can start remembering what they are and figuring out what words mean by looking at them. This is a great word study. So in third grade, you might have a notebook and maybe you jot them down because as you come across more and more words that have these Greek and Latin roots in them, if you know these, it can help you to understand what some new words mean. Let me show you what I mean. Okay, so you might put in your notebook, astro or aster, can be spelled two different ways, but when you see this little cluster of letters, this root, you're gonna know that it has something to do with a star or outer space. When you see photo, you're gonna know that that means light. Anytime we see graph, we're gonna think something written. And then tele simply means far. Okay, so here are some Greek and Latin roots. Let's see if we can kind of match our words to some definitions. So I have this one here. A picture made by a camera capturing light. Okay, I've got geographer or photograph. Yeah, now this one was kind of an easy one today because I know you know this word already, but let's look at our parts. We have photo, which means light, and graph, which means something written. And what is a photograph? Well, it's a picture made by a camera capturing light. Good. So then our second one, we kind of already know, is going to be a geographer, which is simply the study of Earth's surface. And so they're going to make a map of what the Earth's surface looks like. Okay, let's do just a quick little bit of practice with some of these. So if your teacher were to ask you to practice some of them, this might be what they're going to ask you to do. So you're going to remember that Our vowel team syllables have one vowel sound. And so in here it says, read each sentence, underline the word with a vowel team syllable, and then circle that vowel team syllable. Let me switch out my pens. Let's do a bright colored one. Okay, let's read this out loud, big and loud. Here we go. He explained how to get to the lake from his home. Do you see a word that has a vowel team syllable? Oh, right here. I see the A-I, right? Okay, so here is our word that has that vowel team syllable. I underlined it. Maybe I should circle it because I wasn't following directions. Let's try it again. So she is reading the novel that you gave me. Do you see a vowel team? Yeah, right here. So here's our word, and then we're going to circle our vowel team just like that. Excellent. Let's do one more. He repeats the sentence so we can write it correctly. Okay, do you see any of those vowel teams? Yep, right here. And I see it right there. So training our brains to recognize those. Excellent. Let's skip down here and look at some of those Greek and Latin roots. Again, we have them just written here, astro, graph, photo, and tele. So you might have those in your notebook so that you can practice them this week. Right now, what I want us to do, we're going to read the sentence and underline that root word or the word with the root, astro, graph, photo, or tele. We're just identifying it. Okay, let's go through and see what we can find. The astronaut told us about his space mission. Do you see one with that root? Yeah, right here. Okay, and I checked out a biography on Thomas Edison at the library. Yes, biography has graph in it. Excellent job. All right, I want to just finish out today. I just have one quick little thing, because as we are looking and thinking about Greek and Latin roots, there are some little small pieces we're going to come across. Here is one today. We're just going to look at this one. Fin. Fin means end. So when we look at a sentence like this and it says, our final exams start in about 2 weeks, we know that final, because it has that fine in there, or fin, we know that final is not referring to first, grand, or amazing. It's actually referring to last. So by knowing what that means, we can go through and figure out what that word means. We can use our context clues. We can use knowing our Greek and Latin roots, all of those different things. Third grade, it was fantastic getting to hang out with you this morning as you're getting ready for school. Remember, you are responsible for your learning success. So listen, ask questions, and share your ideas, because together we can do so much more. I can't wait to see you back here tomorrow on PBS. I've got some new words to show you. We're going to practice all of those Greek and Latin letters and sounds and roots. Can't wait to see you then. Take care, be safe, and I'll see you tomorrow. Bye-bye.
Good morning to a brand new day. Time to learn and games to play. Learning things is so much fun. Learning is good for everyone.